Good scrum for the
Great
Gators.
Job by the Gators. Sully Murphy running down. Unfortunately, he will not get there in time, and the Gators will get the try. Great job by the Gators back. I believe it was the inside center, doing a great job at committing those defenders, finding the gap, and then offloading it. And as anticipated, folks, this is going to be a great game of rugby. The score to be determined shortly after this conversion. And that kick is good. The score is 7-7. Both teams looking to get ahead. Plenty of rugby to go with 28 minutes left in this first half.
High deep kick, nicely caught by the fullback for the Gators.
And they'll pick and go, their scrum half having taken into contact. Nice deep kick by Gators. That'll go out of the park. The touch judge calling it out pretty deep. Theo Espanol now looking to get the line out going.
It's a good line out from the GGs, but an unfortunate pass makes them have to track backwards and recover the ball.
James Fleming with a great stiff arm. Connor Billow with great steps. Kieran Blair getting a word from the touch judge for disrupting the game. Glenroy unable to find touch, and that ball will stay in. The Gators will now kick it right back. And that'll hit our booth. It'll be line out for the GGs. The Spaniard looking to lead his team to victory. Connor Billow with an explosive run to get the Gators on the back foot. Evan Roy getting stopped at the line. He will offload it to Sully, who will knock it forward, and that ball is recovered by the Gators. Graham Neil Klein doing a great job at cutting off the space. The Spaniard, very vocal on this pitch. And the GGs doing a great job with their line speed. However, a little slow to set up, and there seems to be a slight overlap, although Graham Neal Klein is here covering, and the Gators will reverse direction. Connor Billows recovering the ball with Jacob Harries there in support. Zach Campbell with a nice inside pass to Jamie Armstrong, who will be taken down. The Spaniard taking it into contact. And Dion with a great run. These Gators have, for the first time, brought absolute aggression to these GGs. The GGs have not faced an opponent like this yet, with great line speed, great power as well. But the GGs doing a great job at securing their ball and breaking the line.
And getting the penalty.
Not rolling away call against the Gators. Dion attempting to take it quick, but the ref will call that back.
Gigi's choosing to go for a kick.
Yeah. Now, I think this is the good call, given that the wind... Oh, no, they'll go for the point. Now, the wind is against them, but Jamie Armstrong clearly confident in his boot, and I don't blame him. He's got one hell of a boot.
I think the wind agrees with you. It's settled down a bit now, so hopefully it's
I mean, when
calm.
A team gives you free points, you got to take them.
For sure.
So this is an opportunity for them to continue to chisel at that scoreboard and continue to put points up. But the GGs will have to stay disciplined and chase this if it does not go where it should. The Gators bringing a great fan base with them and chirping Jamie Armstrong. That kick is unfortunately missed left. And that'll now be a 22-yard drop. Nice high drop kick over the head of Glenn Roy. And that'll go out of bounds. James Fleming eager to go quick, but Glenn Roy telling him no. I'm sure the coach will have a word with them after that play. A drop kick ought usually never to go out of bounds like that, especially off a bounce. And now it'll be Gigi's line out in their own 20-yard line. Jacob Harries unable to catch it cleanly, but he will knock it back. Jamie Armstrong will go into contact. Sully will give it to Big Tuna, who will go into contact. That ball is still secured. Wade Marshall getting into a little funny business after the ruck with his counterpart. And these Bishop's Gators are known to enjoy those types of battles after the play. Connor Billow recovering. Eroy punching through the defensive line. Jamie Armstrong with a nice high kick. That will be caught by the Gators, but the GG's defensive line is there. The ref is calling a penalty against the Gators. Offside by the Gators. And Glenn Roy will now look to find touch this time. And he will find it. Gigi's line out at the 45-yard line. Dion with a great catch. Unfortunately, Sully will drop the ball forward, and that'll now be I'm not sure what the penalty is here, but it'll be a penalty against the GGs, and the Gators will now have an opportunity to go on the offensive. The GGs finding the Gators finding touch deep into the GGs zone.
I think the GGs just need to shake off that last line out and be strong.
Ooh. Absolutely. Jacob Harry's doing a great job at disrupting it. Great tackle by Graham Neal Klein. Absolutely crushing hit. And they'll call the initial knock on back. And it'll be Gators scrum. Things a little slow to get going here, but we're sure to see an exciting scrum. A nice up and over by the Gators 10. The ball is recovered by Simba, who is now taken down at the 1 yard line. Sully with the nice box kick to clear the zone.
Yeah, that was initially a really nice bounce, bouncing back into the field instead of out, but unfortunately, or luckily, the GGs got there first and give themselves a bit more space for this line out instead of it being on like the 5 yard line.
Yeah. But the Gators doing a great job in their line out. Jacob Harry's attempting to disrupt it. They'll fake him out, but the Gators unable to capitalize, and it's recovered by Waheed Hamidi, who is taken down. Sully again with the box kick, and again he will find some space. The GGs inching their way up the field, doing a great job at disrupting this lineout.
The ref's called an not straight pass, so we'll see what we're going to do. I think we're going into a scrum.
The ref stopping this one, and we'll see what he calls.
I think the scrum collapsed, but I, you know, there's just so many people.
Well, scrumming is an art in and of itself, and there's tons of different techniques and nuances that go on down there. You know, even just bringing your elbow down can invite
balance,
a penalty.
Yeah.
So. But that ball is won by Bishops. their eight man doing a fantastic job at just breaking through the line and keeping his feet. Zach Campbell being dragged on the floor. The G's will have to get set up here. The Gators doing a great job at spreading the field. And Graham Neal Klein will be there. Simba as well. The Gators doing a great job at exploding on their runs, but they are unable to capitalize here. The GG's defense is relentless. The line speed is good enough at this point, but they will have to keep their eyes up and spread this field. The Gators are looking to spread the field.
Yeah, they got really fast guys on the wing, fast guys in the middle, so they're really a threat anywhere. So hopefully the GG's can keep up the good defensive line and win back possession.
And the GGs will disrupt that ruck, and they'll be rewarded for it once again. And they will have now an opportunity to clear the zone and then hopefully make things happen for themselves. Glenn Roy will line up to kick for touch. And he will find it. Spaniard with a nice far throw. Waheed Hamidi with a nice explosive run. Unfortunately, Big Tuna going into contact. Jamie Armstrong with the cross kick. Unfortunately, he will not find space, and that ball will be caught by the outside center. James Fleming alone on the wing. Zach Campbell, unfortunately, with the missed tackle. Jamie Armstrong attempting to recover. Unfortunately, he cannot get there in time. And that try is scored by the Gators. An unfortunate turn of events, but there's plenty of rugby to be played in this game. Just over 10 minutes left in this first half. Now, the GGs are going to have to remain disciplined. I mean, they had their line out over there. They won the line out. Unfortunately, they're getting beaten in the rucks.
Yeah, I think the Gators are just being extra aggressive right now, just trying to maybe get themselves a points lead and then coast from there. But the GGs just need to keep pushing the way they were right at the beginning and keep that going for the next 10 minutes.
A difficult kick, and it will be missed wide right. So the score is now 12-7 for the Gators.
Thank you.
That ball is caught by the Gators 9, who will dish it out wide. And a nice counter kick. No one there to recover. James Fleming. Taken down by 2 Gators. Andreas with a great run. He's taken down. And Connor Billo on the wing. He's got Simba. And that's some great passing. Connor Billo will look to finish it off. Unfortunately, he cannot get all the way there, but he will keep the ball. And the GGs will now look to return the favor. That ball is lost backwards. Evan Roy.
The ball has been stolen.
Evan Roy unable to secure that ball. That ball slipped through the hands of Big Tuna, and it will once again be kicked back into the GG's territory. Glenn Roy looking to have a go.
But it's being called back for a penalty.
Yeah. So I'm not sure what happened. It must have been on that ruck over there. But the GGs have dodged a bullet, and they will now have the opportunity to once again go on the offensive. Now, I imagine they're discussing whether or not they should go for points. I personally would go for points. Like I said, when you get free points from the other team, you take them. It would certainly shorten the deficit, and then they would get the ball right back. But they will elect for touch. Glenn Roy will find it, and they will look to make their offense happen. The GGs being somewhat successful in the lineouts this game. That ball is disrupted, and they will unfortunately not recover. Jamie Armstrong, recognizing that no one was in the back field, he attempted to recover space. Big Tuna with a nice run to get the Gators on the back foot. Simba finding the space, unable to offload. And that ball will be lost. The Gators will recover it. And the GGs once again, lucky. Getting a penalty. I mean, these are just sort of unacceptable errors by the GGs. When you've got a nice line break, you've got your fastest guy with the ball. Either get deep enough so that he can offload it, or he should just be taking it into contact and hoping to keep the Gators on the back foot. But to just lose the ball like that is unacceptable. And I'm sure the coach will have a talk with them at half. But the GGs are not out of this, and they will get the advantage here. Glenn Roy looking for touch. And he will find it with a nice deep kick. The GGs now with a lineout in Gators territory at the 20-yard line.
Let's see if they can capitalize on this one. That'll be a good way to kind of get close to the end of the first half. See how this goes.
And a nice toss by the Spaniard. Wahid Hamidi is stopped at the line. Big Tuna unable to keep his feet, but that ruck is secured. Andreas Dionysopoulos alone. He will not be held down, and he will regain his feet, gaining yet again another few yards. The Spaniard keeping his feet, doing a great job at going down before being pushed out of bounds. James Fleming there to pick up the ball. Sully telling his team to get in there, and they'll run some pick and goes, hopefully to suck in some defenders. The Gators doing a great job at keeping them up. That ball is thrown out. The ref calling offsides, and a great call by the ref. Now, once again, I usually opt for points, but the GGs, pretty confident in their offense, will have a go at it.
Inching forward, GG's key possession. Let's see, one or two more phases, hopefully. I think they're going to play it out.
Jamie Armstrong with that great inside pass to Connor Billow. The GG's will get that in. And, of course, they risked it, but they got the biscuit. Unclear at this time who scored, but it appears that Zach Campbell will be kicking the conversion here. His first cap in the RSEC. The athletic therapist having a quick chat with Wahid Hamidi. And that kick is good. Zach Campbell will extend the lead. The score is now 14-12 for the GGs. The Gators will now set up the kickoff. The GGs scrambling a bit to set up their kick return. That ball is kicked deep over the head of Jamie Armstrong, and that'll go straight out the back. Now, if I'm not mistaken, they can now elect for a scrum center, which I think they are doing. Great call. The Gators doing a great job.
Last minute and a half, the GG's just going to look to keep possession and just see what they can do with a few seconds remaining.
The Spaniard with a great run. Much speed on the wing. Unfortunately, that pass will be forward and they are unable to capitalize. There will be a scrum down for the Gators at their own 40-yard line. What an explosive run by the Spaniard.
For sure, he saw his gap and he took it.
Yeah. Well, for a front row player, he's got some wheels, that's for sure.
Absolutely.
Unfortunately, Simbo just a little bit too ahead of the ball. Great tackle by Andreas. Great steal by Glenn Roy. And that'll be the half. An absolute battle, 14-12 for our very own U Ottawa GGs. Welcome back, rugby fans. We are just about ready to start the second half. GG's receiving. The score, of course, 14-12 for the GGs. A nice deep kick by the Gators. Glenn Roy will find it, and he will kick that right back. The Gators will recover that one. The GGs with a nice defensive line and great line speed. Eroy and Big Tuna doing a great job at slowing down the Gators forward. Eroy with the missed tackle. Glenn Roy there to cover his brother's behind. And the GGs will get advantage on that. Unable to maintain the ball, it'll be a scrum down for the GGs. An aggressive start to the second half. The Gators looking a little disorganized, and the GGs looking hungrier than ever. Glenn Roy appearing to be playing outside center and Zach Campbell at fullback. Glenn Roy with a great crash. But the Gators doing a great job at disrupting that ruck, and they will get rewarded for it. Their eight will take it quick. Great tackle by Jamie Armstrong. Jamie Armstrong doing a great job at recognizing the defense and organizing his team. The ref will allow that one to play. And an absolutely explosive run by the Gators with a nice series of offloads.
Yeah, the GGs are doing a great job on defense, but the Gators, their offloads are so fast.
Yeah. Well, now it's goal line defense. The GGs will really have to dig deep here. The Gators looking to have a series of pick and goes and eventually send it out wide, which they did. Unfortunately, that ball will be missed backwards. Simba with a missed tackle. Graham Neil Klein unable to support him there. And the GGs will get punished on that one.
Not the start to the half the GGs are looking for, but the Gators are thrilled with that. Take the lead again.
Yeah.
They just need to shake it off. There was just a miscommunication.
Well, that was, an unfortunate series of events. Their defense was set up nicely around here, the 40-yard line, just near the booth. But the Gators did a good job sending it out wide. Then they had those offloads. And then, of course, the pick and goes to suck in some defenders, and the GGs unable to get themselves organized in the on the outside. the Spaniard looking to pump up his team. And it seems they know what to do. They're done discussing. That conversion is made by the Gators fly half, Kalen Abbott.
Axel Montgomery for the conversion.
My apologies, Axel Montgomery
for
the conversion. A nice high kick by Glenn Roy. It is recovered by Axel Montgomery, who will kick it deep right into the hands of Jamie Armstrong. And another missed tackle by Zach Campbell. That ball will not find touch, and Aiden Gregoire So it appears that Aiden Gregoire has come in at scrum half for Sullivan Murphy. Jamie Armstrong appearing to be holding his leg. And a nice box kick by Aiden Gregoire, who will find the hands of the Gators fly half, who will now look to have a run. And a nice tackle by Evan Roy. And a nice line break by the Bishop's Gators. A good job at finding the gap, and they will capitalize on that, extending their lead.
Yeah, I think the GG's just a little tired with so many phases. It's a lot of effort on defense. But still lots of rugby to play, lots of time left.
I mean, a little low on the communication there, I'd say. Unable to recognize what's in front of them and adjusting accordingly. And so they're just getting beat by numbers. And the conversion is good.
Try score by number
the
three,
score
Matthew
now 26 to 14 for the Gators.
The conversion is good.
We have Ali Awada now in the game. I imagine at second row. And Logan Harris as well. Some nice fresh legs, both extremely talented players. Logan Harris with his first RSEC match of the season. And Ali Awada coming off a great couple of games. A nice high kick, recovered by Jamie Armstrong, who is unable to find any players out wide, and so he will take it into contact himself. Big Tuna taking in with a nice offload. Simba Gumbo losing it forward in contact. The Gators having a quick word with the touch judge, upset about something.
Yeah, I'm not honestly sure, but I know some of the players had words with each other as well, so I think they're just, everybody's really riled up at the moment and
yeah.
Just want to slow it down for a second.
I mean, the Gators are known for getting under the skins of their opposing teams. And if you've ever played a game in Lennoxville, you'll know exactly what their fans are like. But still plenty of rugby to be played, just under 30 minutes left in the second half. And there will be a scrum down for the Gators after that lost ball, that ball lost forward in contact. Great tackle by Zach Campbell. Big Tuna and Eroy with two big hits. And a box kick by the Gators to try and gain some territory. It'll be a line out for the GGs and an opportunity to get their offense going. Great line out win by the GGs. Waheed Hamidi looking to break the line. Unfortunately, he's stopped. Ali Awada with a nice catch, and he will go into contact. Big Tuna with a nice run and offload. Eroy losing it forward in contact. Unfortunately, that'll be a knock-on and a scrum down for the Gators. These are undisciplined errors that shouldn't, you know, you'd look to avoid by the third game in the season, Vanessa.
Absolutely.
And it's something that they've been struggling with all season now. It's these balls lost forward. Clearly, they're able to generate their offense. And so forcing the ball when they should just take it in is, it costs them.
For sure. That just takes a bit more practice, a bit more time. Paying attention to where your hands are is a big part of that, too. Sometimes people forget how close or how far apart their hands are, and then the ball's gone.
Yeah. A nice job by the GGs to steal that scrum.
Yeah, as we say that, great job. That penalty now kicking for some space, some territory, because their lineouts have been really great so far.
Now, the GGs have tons of talent on the bench. And I would not be surprised to see some more substitutions coming in soon. Glenn Roy doing a great job at finding touch deep into the Gators' territory. And we'll have a time call. Glenn Roy appearing to be cramping. Never a comfortable situation, but he's back on his feet. And that guy will endure the pain. Waheed with a nice catch on a lineout that was overthrown. Gramuel Klein with a great crash line, and he will find some yards. Aiden Gregoire doing a great job of keeping it quick, and Dion will crash through, and he will get the try. A one-on-one battle against Dion is a one-on-one win for Dion. And that try is scored by number 8, Andreas Dionysopoulos. Zach Campbell now lining up for the conversion. And that kick is good, narrowly missing the post, but luckily finding its way through.
Keeping all of us on our toes.
Yeah.
And
now. The score is 26-21. Zach Campbell with the conversion.
And Zach Campbell with the conversion.
Andreas doing a great job at breaking the line.
Yeah, one try wasn't enough. He's going for more.
Of course. Yeah. Graham Neal Klein with the great inside pass to Evan Roy, who will keep his feet. Eventually going down. That ball will be called out. Connor Billow doing a great job trying to fight his way in and not having it with that opposing lock. The lock, of course, doing the classic Allen Iverson. I don't know if you remember that move. The walk over and stomp, yep. And Connor Billow's not dealing with the disrespect.
It.
And I don't blame him. That ball is not straight, but the ref will allow the GGs to play. Great call by the ref. Yeah, the Gators doing a lot of screaming and not a lot of catching the ball and throwing it straight. So they'll unfortunately get
penalized for that.
Exactly, and it'll be a scrum down for the GGs, who will look to secure this one. The Gators doing a good job at making them work for these ones. The Gators
Absolutely,
have a strong
yeah.
scrum.
Not as big as the GGs, but yeah, definitely a force to be reckoned with.
Now, I really like Aiden Gregoire today playing at 9.
Yeah, I think he is
helping keeping the ball go quick. He's getting quick ball out. The ref will call a broken arm penalty there. Unfortunate turn of events. That's the type of discipline that that the GGs will have to work on. Those types of errors.
I think a big part of those is just the frustration at the moment with Gators aren't exactly, not necessarily clean in every play. So just getting angry.
The Gators with explosive runners and absolutely giving the GG's defense a hard time. Glenn Roy with a nice tackle at the line. And a nice tackle by Evan Roy against his opposing number. Great ankle tackle by Waheed Hamidi to slow down the Gators' offense. And a nice pick and go by the Gators' scrum half. Yeah. The GG's having a hard time now recognizing what's in front of them, and they're just getting beat by numbers, which is unfortunate because they are just as fast and just as powerful. But there, it was a numbers game. The Gators winger there on the end, able to capitalize.
Yeah, just not recognizing where the scrum half is looking to play the ball. I know there was some communication, but I don't think everybody was maybe paying attention there.
Yeah.
And their wing just blew by them. The Gators' wing, I should say.
Now, that will put a slight dent in the GG's comeback, but folks, there is still plenty of rugby to be played. Still just under 20 minutes left in this second half. The Gators up by now 12 points after that conversion.
Transcribed by number 14, Kyle Corrigan.
Which, if we learn anything from the women's game just prior to this one, anything can be done in just a matter of minutes.
For sure.
And a nice high deep kick by Glenn Roy. And that'll get knocked on by the Gators scrum half. And it'll be scrum down for the Ottawa GGs. Now, one thing that the GGs have been doing on offense is, with their scrums is, whenever they are on offense, they put Connor Billow at the 8 position, and on defense, they put Andreas Dionysopoulos at the 8 position. But after seeing those few runs by Dion, I would almost recommend putting him at the 8, letting him take that pick and go on this sort of set piece. Graham Neal Klein with a great explosive run. He will work to gain those extra yards, and he does. Dion in great support of Jamie Armstrong. And the GGs will now pick and go in an attempt to suck in the defenders. Unclear to see what's going on right now.
I think the GGs thought it was a try. It looked like they hesitated.
It did.
For
well,
half
it looked
second.
Like they were celebrating. I don't know if that was held up or if there was a knock on.
Oh, no.
Oh, it appears in Space Jam, and he will just get that ball over the try line to shorten their deficit. And a great explosive play. Graham Neal Klein having an outstanding season, a reliable player, and he's really been at the core of the Ottawa offense. Having a similar play last game against McGill, where they were down and they needed a try. Graham Neal Klein was there, and once again, he's here for his team.
He comes through for his team, for his family, so that's a good...
Zach Campbell lining up for the kick. I mean... Vanessa, this is going to be a one-try game.
Oh, because absolutely. It's if, just back and forth.
Because of that missed conversion kick by the Gators, a try by Ottawa puts them in the lead, and otherwise they're down by one try.
Graham Neal
So there will be no ties today. This will be a one-try game. You heard it here first, folks.
Good catch by the GGs. They look to kick it long, but the
unfortunately, there will be a penalty now against the GGs. Not sure what for. Perhaps an interference call on that kick.
Gators taking their time to set it up. Oh, they are going for kick. Yeah. Like you've been saying all game, if given the opportunity for points, take them right away.
Absolutely, and especially now, this prevents the GGs from simply just scoring that one try.
They're going to need at least
two.
They'll
need exactly a try and another kick. So a fantastic call by the Gators. You have the points on the board, you take them. And with this kicker's boot, I mean, hopefully I can jinx him like I did to the McGill kicker last game. But unfortunately, my powers are not working today, and that kick is good. The score now 36-28. Still tons of rugby to play. 13 minutes is plenty of time to score a try and to attract a penalty deep into the opponent's zone. They will have to play disciplined, however. A few substitutions now. It seems that Jack Schwienard, a.k.a. Chewy, will fill in to the back row, replacing Waheed Hamidi. And a nice high, beautiful high, deep kick by Glenn Roy. But a great run by the Gators. Finally taken down by Big Tuna. And the Gators will look to find space. That ball is recovered by James Fleming, who will have a run, and then he'll whip it out to Aiden Gregoire. Jamie Armstrong finding space. He's alone, and he'll get a nice wide pass to Simba Gumbo, who is unfortunately taken out on the wing, but a beautiful play by Jamie Armstrong. That was a gorgeous, gorgeous pass by Jay Money. Recognizing he was alone, but having the confidence in his arm to dish it out wide to Simba Gumbo. The GGs now have an opportunity to steal the line out, hopefully. But if not, I imagine the Gators will kick for some space, and hopefully the GGs can then make something happen. Just over 10 minutes left in this second half. An absolute nail biter, folks. Now, it didn't appear to be straight, but the ref will let it play. Graham Neil Klein making the tackle. Unfortunately, he was able to, the Gator center was able to dish it off. They will kick and find some touch. Gigi's line out. Logan Harris with a nice line out win. And a nice play by Zach Campbell.
Gigi's taking one out of the Gators playbook, going side to side.
Well, the Gigi's finally taking advantage of their system, which is a 1-3-3-1, which, for those of you who don't know what that is, basically they spread the field wide and add some support to the wingers. So Connor Billow had a nice run over there on the wing. That ball was unfortunately lost in the ruck, and now the Gators will have an opportunity. Great steal by Jamie Armstrong. Unfortunately, he loses possession of it, and the ref will call advantage. Him clearly disappointed because he had both his hands on that one. But a great, great play nonetheless. The clock, of course, is still ticking. Great job by Aiden Gregoire to absolutely bully the Gators scrum half. The Gigi's will now have to play some disciplined defense and hopefully recover the ball, which they do. Aiden Gregoire sending out wide, big tuna. And Graham Neil Klein now in contact. And they've got the numbers. James Fleming unfortunately throwing it away.
But recovered
Jamie Armstrong doing great work on the ground to secure that ball. The Gigi's can still keep it going. Logan Harris with a nice offload. Dion being taken down, but doing a great job at keeping possession. And that ball is thrown away, and the Gators are able to steal it midair. The scrum half with a cheeky run. Logan Harris doing a good job at trying to get his hands there. But that'll be a penalty against the Gigi's. I'm unable to see what for. But the ref having a little chat with Dion. Perhaps hands in the ruck. And the Gators will once again go for points. And again, a good decision by the Gators. Who now force a two-try game. Should they make this kick? And that kick is good. The score now 39-28. With just over 6 minutes left in the second half. Gordy Evans now in the pack, replacing Andreas Dionysopoulos. Alex McClure as well, replacing Connor Billow. Now these guys are hungry, and when they have an opportunity to play, they obviously want to take full advantage. Nice high kick by Glenn. And that is recovered by Ali Awada. Chewy doing a great job at keeping his feet and a really disciplined play, not throwing that away. And a great inside pass by Big Tuna to Gordy Evans, who will break the line. Glenn Roy with a nice run and a great stiff arm. And the GGs keep it going. Big Tuna with a nice crash ball. GNK with a nice clear out. Ali Awada going into contact, and that ball is secured by Logan Harris. Alex McClure helping out in the ruck. Zach Campbell getting taken down. Big Tuna with some good crashes. Oh, and a nice step by Aiden Gregoire. Unfortunately, he's taken down. Scrum half is in, but James Fleming sends it out wide. Graham Neil Klein unable to pass it out wide. Aiden Gregoire taken down. Logan Harris going alone, but he will break the line. Great job. And he will do tons of work on the ground to keep possession. And a great clear out by Evan Roy. Interesting decision by the GGs. Although it is disciplined play. Jamie Armstrong looking to break the line. Simba Gumbo alone. The GG's desperate for a try here, but they are playing disciplined rugby. And I imagine we'll see a series of pick and goes. The Spaniard doing a great job. The ref will call a penalty back. I guess they were playing advantage. Yes, an offside penalty against the Gators. Jamie Armstrong will organize his offense. And this is a must-score situation. I mean, they need to score quick here. And then great,
and they do.
Great pass to Graham Neil Klein once again, generating that offense and breaking the line. And a great little head fake by Jamie Armstrong to really sell the pass to Evan Roy, but instead dishing it to Graham Neil Klein. And a good conversion by Zach Campbell, who does not crack under the pressure and makes that conversion in between the posts. Now, generally speaking, after a try, you always kick to the opposing team because territory is always much more important than ball possession. However, when we are nearing down the end of the game, the GGs will need to get the possession of the ball and then keep possession. So the fact that they're getting the ball now, even if it's deep in their own zone, is perhaps the only opportunity they'll have left to come back into this game. And so they'll really have to play discipline. And as expected, that ball was kicked deep, but it's caught by Aiden Gregoire, who will now find Ali Awada. And the GGs will really have to play discipline here and keep possession of this ball. Nice hands. Simba Gumbo on the wing, but he's chased down by the lock. Great offload to Graham Neil Klein, who will find space. He's alone. Zach Campbell will have to secure that. And just like that, folks, they are back into the Gators' 35-yard line.
Two really great runs cut the field in half.
And they'll have to stay disciplined. Eroy. Big Tuna with a nice explosive run, and that ball is secured by the Spaniard. Jamie Armstrong with a great play. That is just absolutely unfortunate. They'll call the knock on. Simba Gumbo attempting to keep the ball in bounds will pass to Jamie Armstrong, who unfortunately was not able to cleanly catch it, and the ref will call the knock-on. Time is dwindling down.
And the Gators going to take as much time as possible.
This is essentially last play of the game. Yeah. The GGs need to steal this scrum. They've got the skill. They've got the power. Alex McClure looking to maybe burst off the scrum and take down that 10 before he can kick. But, I mean, even an 8-man pick and just kick it out, or an 8-man pick and take the ruck. This is an absolute battle. And they
massive
do a fantastic
drive.
Job at winning that
there
ruck, that scrum. Chewy doing a great job. Unfortunately, he stopped at the line. Great decision to keep that ball. Logan Harris keeping his feet. And the GGs will just have to ground and pound and dig deep. This is their opportunity. The Spaniard with a nice pick and go. And they'll look to get another pick and go. The fans absolutely roaring here. But the Gators are relentless on defense. They are holding their line. I would not be surprised if Jamie Armstrong calls for the ball soon.
Yeah, the defense is getting really sucked in. It's time to
absolutely,
pop it
that's
out
what
wide.
It is. Jamie wants it. Graham Klein clearly there. He's saying he wants it. And they
and
get
it.
The Gigi score. Sorry, hold on, folks. The ref is waiting. My apologies. I may have spoken too soon. The GG's clearly happy. The Gators clearly unsure. The ref going to have a word with his touch judge. I don't think the touch judge could see anything from that angle. We'll see what they call. They call it! The GG's score! An unbelievable comeback by the GG's in what could have been, or what is, the most important game of this season. The GGs have mounted an unbelievable comeback.
Yeah, what a great display of just pure
and that
grit.
Was scored by number 3, Evan Roy, 19-year-old, straight from Ottawa. That is pure determination and an absolute turning point for the GGs in their season. Zach Campbell will now line up the kick. An important win for the GGs. And that is the game, folks. You have just witnessed some RSEC rugby history as the GGs just mounted an unbelievable comeback against the 2-0, or now 2-1 Gators. And I am sure they will likely meet again in the playoffs. Folks, thank you for tuning in, and have a great rest of your day.